another one. When you're a child, you learn there are three dimensions: height, width, and depth. Like a shoebox. Then later you hear there's a fourth dimension: time. Then some say there can be 5, 6, 7. I knock off work, have a beer at the bar. I look down at the glass and feel glad.
A film about poetry. That's an odd notion in itself.
I guess so. You know, it didn't seem so odd to me. I remember giving the script, sending it first to Ron, and he called me and said, "Wow, Jim, I think you're really going for the big bucks here. A poet who's a bus driver in New Jersey, you know?" But I don't, yeah, I mean, I've had a lot of references to poets in previous films, from mentioning Robert Frost and Walt Whitman in Down by Law. I made a film called Dead Man in which the main character's name is William Blake. I've had other poems or poets mentioned in other films. But yeah, this one actually a story about a poet.
Where does that come from? I mean, is it an interest of yours in poetry?
Well, yes. I'm from Northeast Ohio, a suburb of Akron, and as a teenager I discovered first translations of Baudelaire and then Rimbaud, and consequently I read Hart Crane and Walt Whitman and then Wallace Stevens, and these guys kind of led my way out of there in a way. Emily Dickinson was very important to me. So I don't know, they were like kind of beacons of the world outside. Also, people like Baudelaire and Rimbaud were really kind of rebellious. I looked at them as like kind of badass rebels, you know, living how they wanted and changing your perception. And poets don't do it for the money, you know, so they meant it. So they were really guides for me. So I've been interested in poetry for a long time.